Well, according to Human Rights Group, International Human Rights Organization, Bahrain today considered to be one of the worst countries in human rights. And it is categorized in many organizations that work for freedom of expression. It is one of the most repressive regime. Unfortunately, you don't read about it internationally, you don't see about it internationally because no media are allowed to get into the country, no journalists are allowed to get to the country, nobody are allowed to write in the internet or in Twitter or Facebook about what's happening on Bahrain because they could be targeted. We have thousands of people behind bar today, and that's a very big percentage if you take into consideration the population of Bahrainis, which is something about 700,000 people. Population of 700,000 people, at least 50,000 people of them went in or out jail in the past 3 months. Some of them were released, some of them sentenced for 10, 15, 20, 30, 40, 100 years just for practicing their right in freedom of assembly, freedom of gathering, freedom of expression. So you have remaining at least 4,000 people in jail, and this is also the highest percentage of a political prisoner you will find around the world. There are approximately 40 people arrested on a weekly basis, many of them children. Today the school in Bahrain is starting. At least 200 to 300 children will not be able to go to the school because they are in jail because of gathering or things related to freedom of expression. So you have thousands of people left the country, run out from the repression. Thousands of people are hidden, living inside their home. Tens of homes being raided on a daily basis. People are attacked in the street. Houses being raided. Things, wealthy things, valuable things being stolen by the security people who come from many Asian and Arab countries. As you know, also people were targeted based on their sectarian background, because the majority of people fighting for democracy are Shia. So on that basis, the government targeted them, demolished at least 5% of their mosques in the past few years. So you're facing the most repressive regime, and unfortunately you don't read about it in the Western countries, because it's not only the media cannot get in, it's not only government don't allow the media and human rights group to get in, but many countries like UK want to cover that because Bahrain considered to be one of their strongest allies and arms market. So UK been doing PR directly or indirectly for Bahrain government in the past years. So we fall to be a victim of many factors. One factor is the ruled by dictators, a repressive family. But then again, we are a victim of the international foreign policy, hypocritic policy of many Western government. And that's why we say it's a time that for us as NGOs, international NGOs, British, Bahraini, to highlight this double standard and to show how much people around the world are paying high price because of this double standard foreign policy. So this is a bit summary.
Yeah.
Of what is going on Bahrain, and as I'm talking to you.